Hello friends!
Today I would like to talk about a symbol, ancient symbol, fish. Just right after the symbol mermaid will be fish. So, main reason why I'm talking about it, because it's a lot of stories in different countries, in different cognitive traditions, we have symbol fish. Like a main idea about the symbol is that it represent female sexuality. Yes. And yes, it was the symbol of the earliest Christian people who wanted to meet each other. And between them, they have this symbol fish that you know, and you can Google just the two lines like this. And they kind of the password to make the meeting and worship the Jesus cross. Also, it was a very familiar symbol to Romans, so they will not think that it is something new. So it was a very known symbol of the fertility and a female goddess that represents in many cultures and was very famous that time of the earliest Christianity. In different countries, we have a different stories. And for example, one story that in Hinduism, Matsya, the hero, the god, avatar of Vishnu, representing, if you will see the pictures in the different temples or Google research, it will be a symbol of kind of mermaid as well. So it will be half a human as a man and a half fish. Or it will be image that the human man body will be inside the fish, kind of in the mouth. And it is beautiful story about Vishnu avatar, Matsya, that also very connected to the Noah Ark and the flood that also represents in many countries. So actually a lot of symbols that we think they are Christian or this newest religions actually were a kind of not stolen but taken for advertising the new religions. For example, Christianity took a lot of symbols to make the easiest way to convert people to Christianity from the paganism. So let's have a little bit of a journey in the world. Okay, we many of us use feng shui in our homes, and this Chinese tradition seeing fish as a symbol of luck and wealth and represented with number 9. So let's go to Babylon. Babylonian mythology has very beautiful story about the fish, a giant fish who pushed the egg to the river of Euphrates, and out of this egg emerged goddess of fertility, mermaid Atargatis. And later, Atargatis' son was named by Ichthus. That is very familiar for you as a pronunciation of the Jesus later. Let's go to Africa. In African tradition, fish represent cosmic womb. So again, goddess of fertility, again, feminine energy. And represent creativity and transformation. In many traditions, when I did my research, I understood that many culture make this fish symbols of the let it go with the flow, like the fish is in the water moving freely, and also represents the freedom and overcome of the hardship, because the fish is so flexible, and for you to overcome the hardship, you need to be kind of flexible and kind of let it go, let it come as it is and let it go. So do not have these mind barriers that stopping you to accept what life is giving you, what is life water, what is life source is giving you in your life now, in this moment. Native Americans. There are a lot of myths and stories, legends about giant fish. They were worship salmon particularly, and some few different fishes, but mostly salmon. And one of the beautiful stories was when this giant fish salmon married a beautiful woman, and this also became a mermaid after that. And the symbol represent long life, again fertility and wisdom. Also, when I do my presentations and speeches about symbols that I draw and paint on my paintings, I also do a lot of drawings with the fish that you will just see here in a different screen. And I always say that fish represents, yes, guru, knowledge, Jesus, as a guru, as a person who brings the knowledge, represents wisdom. And for me, it's, I also use the fish in my paintings as a guide. Like in an ocean of life, we can lose ourselves very, very easy. But with the wisdom, with the intuition that embedded inside us, with the guide, we are always on the right time, in the right place, and we know the direction where we go. And to all men, don't be upset. Also, fish for you is a very good symbol because it is brings you the energy of the warrior, of the protector, for your family, power, being in the power of your life and be active and enthusiastic in your life every day, your daily life. Also, when I paint my portrait of dream for people, individual paintings, I also use a lot a simple fish, because fish is kind of the goddess and queen of the all waters. Yes, and we are 70% water, so fish is also represent the life inside us. Zodiac, Pisces, one of the very relaxed zodiac sign, and also very creative. And from the fish itself, the symbol itself, we can learn also how to read the current situation in your life, kind of the water where you in now. Also, if you wanted to do some of your own research and maybe go deeper with the symbol and other symbols around, I was listening recently a very good lecture of the Professor Peter Knight, British, who wrote a lot of books about the symbols, and I was listening the lecture that name Stolen Images, that he give you the understanding with a lot of examples how ancient symbols from different cults and myth came to the Christianity. So make the conclusion. Symbol fish represents fertility, female energy, let things go, adaptability, learn how to be creative in the moment with the current situation, yes, learn how to read the moment that life gives you, be flexible. And it's a good luck and wealth symbol in many Chinese philosophies and cults. And Just be creative. Allow your intuition speak. Allow your intuition sing the song for you. And listen this. Have a beautiful week ahead. And stay happy and creative.